Hey again, it's Jason from Fraser Valley Rose Farm. I'm here today to ask the question, do you have enough air in your potting soil? Now, if I was checking if I had enough air in my tires, I'd use something like this, but I couldn't quite find a way to stick that onto my nursery pot. So I've got to find a different method of checking how much air is in my potting soil. I'll show you that method here today. It's very easy. And I'm also going to explain to you exactly why it's important that you have enough air in your potting soil. So just a little bit of basic biology goes into this conversation in that the leaves of your plants use sunlight and air and water to make sugar, and they send that all the way through to the tissues of the plants. And when they get down to the roots are net consumers of those sugars. They use that sugar to grow and to survive, so they need that energy. And they take up that energy, they use that energy through a process called aerobic respiration, or if you're a human, you might call that breathing. So they need to be able to breathe. They need sufficient oxygen around the root zone through pockets of air so that they can use that energy and survive. And if they don't have it, they'll die on you. So the properties of your potting soil then have to be able to deliver, obviously, nutrients and water, but most importantly as well, they also have to be able to deliver air to your plant. So I'm going to show you how to test that. And the way I'm going to do it is use a jar like this. Now you can use any size of container. And this size here, I'm going to fill it with the soil. And the important thing about the container that you use is only that you know what the volume of the container is. You're just packing it not tight. You're not trying to push the soil in. You're just putting in the soil the same way you would into a nursery pot as you fill it with soil for planting. And in this case, I'm just going to smooth it out across the top there. And the reason I like this one here is because it's exactly 500 mils. I tested it, I measured it, it's exactly 500 milliliters. So the measurement of the volume of this is important. You have to know exactly what volume you're filling it to so that when you measure how much water drains out of it, that you'll get an exact measurement. So what I'm going to do then is I'm going to fill this up and fill all the air spaces with water. Then I'm going to drain that and measure what drains out of it. And in theory, everything that drains out of it until it stops draining should represent the exact volume of the air-filled porosity that's in that pot after you've drained the pot after irrigation. So once I get a percentage from that, then I'll know if there's sufficient air in this potting soil. Let me show you exactly how to do it. Okay, time for me to start filling this with water. And the important thing about filling with water is I'm just not trying to displace all of the soil. I'm just gently filling all of the air spaces between it with water. And you may have to practice some patience during this step. I can see bubbles coming out there as all of the air that's in that soil profile is displaced. And I'm going to wait for the water to drain, and then pour in a little bit more. And if you look lower down on the jar now, I'm going to point it out, you can see it's filling. And when that reaches the top, when I can see the top glistening with water and level with water, then I'll know that all of the air spaces are filled. And that's it. See, just a couple of air bubbles there, but it's totally level to the top. And so the same volume of soil is now filled entirely with water. And I've taken the top of this old peanut butter jar here, and I've also drilled a bunch of holes in it. So now that we've got it all filled, and I'll tighten that on so it doesn't leak out the sides. Then I'm going to place it and measure how much water easily drains from this. Okay, for the next part here, it actually seemed a little reluctant to let go of its air until I put a little tip into it like this. And I guess that makes sense to let the air come in through some of those holes. And as you can see, I hope you get this on the camera, the air bubbling back up into the soil solution along the front edge of that jar. Okay, with the draining complete, you can see the actual soil has lost a tiny bit of volume there, probably a couple of tablespoons, so there may be a little bit of inaccuracy in the result because of that. And the water that's drained out is 125 milliliters. So if you do the division, what you do is you divide the drainage water by the original volume, and that gives you a percentage. In this case, 125 divided by 500 gave me 0.25 or 25% air-filled porosity. And that's actually a pretty decent number for a potting soil. This here is a sunshine mix. It's a peat and perlite based mix. And so I would expect a really decent air-filled porosity there. So to give you some idea of what the right ranges are, 20 to 25% might be a pretty decent range for a nursery potting soil. Any higher than that, if you go to 25 and 30%, you're probably looking at a propagation mix, something that you're using for early starting. It might give the roots a bit of a boost getting through this loose soil, but it will require more frequent watering, and anything much higher than that, and you end up having to water extremely frequently. It's going to get pretty hard to manage in a nursery situation. If you get much below 20 into that 15 or 10 range, that's going to be hard for your plants to get enough air to their roots, and so you may end up with problems with root rot and so on through the growing cycle. So if it tests much below 20, but preferably more towards 25, in that range is a pretty good one. I'm going to test a second soil here. This one here is my bark and wood fiber based mix that I use frequently. I want to see what that one does. Okay, I've filled the jar here with some of my wood fiber based mix. This is just composted wood bark and wood fiber that I get from a local supplier, and I'm curious to see how it does. So same procedure, take my time and fill the whole jar with water. And now once again, with it all filled, I can just drain it into this jar. Okay, and on my second soil here, I've got the drainage water, and it comes out as 110 milliliters. So again, divide that by 500, and you end up with about 22% air-filled porosity, which is still within a pretty decent range for growing. So I'm pretty happy with that. I hope that this has been a useful discussion for you. I'll add a link below that goes through some of those air-filled porosity percentages, I think quite nicely, and sums up what they mean if you do a test like this on your own potting soil. And thank you so much for watching. If you have any questions, please leave those below the video.